Imagine this. If men lost their strength, their hormones, their sleep, and their ability to think straight in their 50s, do you think the world would stay quiet? Not a chance. Governments would even divert their military budget to solve the problem. So why have we been ignoring menopause, something that affects half the world's population? I'm Dr. Angela Mailis, and today we'll speak about menopause. Menopause happens when a woman stops getting her period for 12 months. This means her ovaries stop releasing eggs and making two important hormones, estrogen and progesterone. But guess what? Changes often start years earlier in a phase called perimenopause and can last years after in postmenopause. The average age of menopause? Around 52. Some women go through it early, even before 40, and symptoms can last over 10 years. So what do women experience? Hot flashes and night sweats, trouble sleeping, mood swings, anxiety and brain fog, joint pain and stiffness, vaginal dryness or painful intercourse, more frequent urination, hair loss and skin changes, muscle loss, weight gain, and increased body fat. We also lose bone and may develop osteoporosis. But often we don't know it until we suffer a fracture. For some, it feels like their bodies are changing overnight, but others barely notice it. Have you ever had a night where you just couldn't sleep? Now imagine that, every night, for months and sometimes years. Or feeling like you're sitting in front of a scorching oven many times a day or night. When women talk to their doctor, many feel unheard. Shockingly, only 7% of doctors in the US say they're trained to treat menopause. That leaves millions of women turning to unregulated pills and supplements, fueling a $22 billion industry in the US alone. Let's now talk treatment. For many women, the most effective option is hormone therapy. It replaces the hormones your body no longer produces and helps with hot flashes, night sweats, vaginal dryness, bone loss, and many more. In 2002, a major study called the Women's Health Initiative raised fears about hormone risks. Many doctors stopped prescribing hormones, and millions of women around the world were left to suffer. But new research shows that for most women under 60, the benefits of hormones by far outweigh the risks. And for women in early menopause, hormone therapy is especially important to protect the heart and bones. Examples of other treatment options include non-hormone medications, weight loss and dietary changes, cognitive behavioral therapy and mindfulness, and developing better sleep habits. Now, to clarify a confusing term, what are bioidentical hormones? Bioidentical hormones are made to match the hormones your body naturally makes, are FDA and Health Canada approved and well-regulated. Others come from compounding pharmacies, which may not be as strictly tested. Always speak with a qualified health provider about what is safe and effective for you. Remember, menopause is not just a phase, it's a powerful lifelong change. So why not treat it with the respect and care it deserves? If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, leave a comment, and don't forget to subscribe. We've got more episodes coming your way. See you in the next episode.